This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Forth and Bargy dialect, also known as Yola, is an extinct variety of English once spoken in the baronies of Forth and Bargy in County Wexford, Ireland. It is thought to have evolved from Middle English, which was brought to Ireland during the Norman invasion, beginning in 1169. As such, it was similar to the Fingallian dialect of the Fingal area. Both became extinct in the 19th century, when they were replaced by modern Hiberno-English. The name Yola means old in the dialect Yola Hut, refurbished in Tagoat, County Wexford, Ireland. Contents 1 History 2 Phonology 3 Grammar 31 Pronouns 32 Articles 33 Verb 34 Nouns 4 Vocabulary 41 Interrogative Words 42 Prepositions 43 Pronouns 44 Other Words 45 Cardinal Numbers 5 Modern South Wexford English 6 Example 61 A Forth and Bargy Song 62 Address to Lord Lieutenant in 1836 63 The Maiden of Rosslare 7 See also 8 Notes 9 References 10 External links History Forth and Bargy Forth and Bargy shown within Ireland. The dialect was spoken in County Wexford, particularly in the baronies of Forth and Bargy. This was the first area English speakers came to in the Norman invasion of Ireland, supporting the theory that the dialect evolved from the Middle English introduced in that period as such. It is thought to have been similar to Fingallian, which was spoken in the Fingal region north of Dublin. Middle English, the mother tongue of the Old English community, was widespread throughout southeastern Ireland until the 14th century, as the Old English were increasingly assimilated into Irish culture. Their original language was gradually displaced through Gaelicization after this point. The Forth and Bargy dialect and Fingallian were the only attested relics of this original form of English. Modern English was widely introduced by British colonists during and after the 17th century, forming the basis for the modern Hiberno-English of Ireland. The new varieties were notably distinct from the surviving relic dialects as English continued to spread. Both the Forth and Bargy dialect and the Fingal dialect died out in the 19th century. Phonology is in the Dutch language, in southwestern varieties of English, and to a lesser extent in German. Most voiceless fricatives in Forth and Bargy became voiced. The Middle English vowels are well preserved, having only partially and sporadically undergone the changes associated with the Great Vowel Shift. One striking characteristic of Forth and Bargy was the fact that stress shifted to the second syllable of words in many instances. Morsale, morsel, hatchet, hatchet, dinnery, dinner, reader, reader, wedding, wedding, etc. Grammar pronouns. Forth and Bargy pronouns were similar to Middle English pronouns. First and second person. First person, second person, third person. Singular, plural, singular, plural, singular, plural. Nam, ik, wow, we, thou, ye, hea, shu. Forth and Bargy verbs had some conservative characteristics. The second and third person plural endings were sometimes eth, as in Chaucerian English. The past participle retained the Middle English y prefix as ee. Nouns. Some nouns retained the n plural of me, children, such as bin, bees, and tren, trees. Vocabulary. The glossary compiled by Jacob Poole provides most of what is known about Forth and Bargy vocabulary. Poole was a farmer and member of the Religious Society of Friends from Growtown in the parish of Tagman on the border between the barony of Bargy and Shelmalier. He collected words and phrases from his tenants and farm laborers between 1800 and his death in 1827. Although most of its vocabulary is Anglo-Saxon in origin, Forth and Bargy contains many borrowings from Irish and French interrogative words. English Forth and Bargy Scots Frisian. Low Saxon Dutch German Gothic who fho wa fa in Doric Scots wa wel, Joaquin we wer as what fade wit fit in Doric Scots wat. Wat wat was at when fan wan fan in Doric Scots wanir 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 wan an where fidi war fower in Doric Scots wr. Wo, wanim war woar y farthu y fy in Doric Scots warum 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 which wilk hawker welk welk. Welsha ilakes how fow who ho wo, wones ho we I prepositions. English Forth and Bargy Scots Frisian Low Saxon Dutch German. About a but about om, run rund om, rond rund above a bua buin bop baven buven uber against ainst again tischen. Gigan tegan gigan among under, Tuscan mang, Tuscan under, Tuscan unter, Zwischen around errant arund om, rond at, by. Adh, be at, by om, bijbei before avar afore foar vor vor below, beneath, under alog ablo, anath, unner under tonetern, netter, unen, unner. Beneden, onder unten, unter beside, next to beside, nicht asyd, neist nest, najanken blangen, neven naast neben between, betwixt, twixt betwixt, betish atwine, atwaish tusken tuschen tussen zwischen for vor. For foar for vor fur from vrom, vrem, vrem frey fan vun van von in I, ing in, I, yn in. In out ut, udhoot ut uut uit aus over oer, oer over over uber through true through. Trock door dirch upon, pa upon, upo, op auf with we y may mit met mit. Pronouns English forth and bargy Scots Frisian Low Saxon Dutch German all owl all alla any ani, ot oni. Elts enig, eender einig each, every earchi, earch, eric, everich ilk, ilka, ivory elts elk, jeed, jeedine elk, eider jetter few vu few, a wain min venic weaning venic. Neither nother nather knock weeder none, nothing nooshed, noting nane, knock nimin, neat nums, nix niemand, neats, nix niemand, nix other ori ither or. Anner under, and dear and dearsome zim sum guan welk samij einage this, that dicky, dicka this, that dis, dat dit, deuce, dat dit, dies, dat deser, das other words. English forth and bargy Scots Frisian Low Saxon Dutch German Irish Wexford Wiseforth Wexford, Wexford. Wexford. Wexford lit West Vordi. Wexford lit Westford Loch Garman. Sun zin sun sine sun zon zana grian land lone, lone land talam day day, die. Day day dag dag tagia yourself thiesel yourself disels du sulvest, sulvin jezelf du selber tu fine friend vreen fear freon. Frund vreend freund kara the a, ee the da, it da, den, dat da, het die, der, das, dem, den, dayan, na thing ding thing ting ding ding. Ding rud, ni go ee go guy, gang, gon jean gon gen dull go, ameyacht go away fear veer fear freeze fort, bang, angst v rees, angst furkt, angst eagla. Old Yola, Yol ald ooled, ol ood alt shan, sianda, aosta cardinal numbers 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. 10 o an tweet twin dhree vau vive zs 7 it neen dhen compare Dorset dialect 1, 2, 3, vower, vive, 6, 7, it, 9, 10 modern South Wexford English traditional thatched cottage near Banno Bay in Bargy Yola Farm refurbished in Tagoat, Co. Wexford, Ireland. Diarmaid O'Murith travelled to South Wexford in 1978 to study the English spoken there. His informants ranged in age between 40 and 90. Among the long list of words still known or in use at that time are the following. Amain, going on ama and equals getting on well bolsker, an unfriendly person chy, a little drazed, threadbare fash, confusion, in a fash keek, to peep sock, to sunbathe, to relax in front of the fire quare, very, or, extremely, amain is a Norman word which means, of easy use. Example A Forth and Bargy song. The following is a Forth and Bargy song, with a rough translation into English. Yola zong fade teal the zo lorna, ko joan, zo nagi th, weethist all kirka, wafer, and corny lij woos and a log, tis gay and louthy, huck nyer, yar scudding, fartu zo hatchy well, gosp, kahulbi zade, mothi fartu, and fade. Ha date aus var gabble, tell ee zin go to glade cham a stook, and a donal, wool li out ee day th valor waspeen here, th, las ee chorch hey your sti wahad a bree, gisting oor hone, aar gentrize where bibern, omzeel su no stowing yeeth muslier had ba hole, twas me tamine, at by mislik was ee pit to drive in jude and maud vrem earchi ete was ee lock zich vaporing, and shimmering, fan ee doff ee aar scoff. Zich blaking, and blaying, fan ee ball was ee drow. Chote well aar aim was touz anur a blow mo wall aar boust, high soon was ee tight at aar aron was var aiming, r n jish ee height zich vezine, tarvezine, tell then whene'er ze nor zickle ne'er well, no, nor ne'er may. There are nine more verses an old song. What ails you so melancholy, quoth John, so cross? You seem all snappish, uneasy, and fretful. Lie with us on the clover, tis fair and sheltered, come nearer, you're rubbing your back, why so ill-tempered? Well, gossip, it shall be said, you ask what ails me. nor such never will, no, nor never may address to Lord Lieutenant in 1836 congratulatory address in the dialect of Forth and Bargy, presented to the Lord Lieutenant of Ireland the Earl of Mulgrave Constantine Henry Phipps on his visit to Wexford in 1836 taken from the Wexford Independent newspaper of 15 February 1860 The paper's editor Mr. Edmund Hoare writes, the most remarkable fact, in reality, in connection with the address is this in all probability it was the first time regal or vice-regal ears were required to listen to word of such a dialect, and it is even still more probable that a like event will never happen again, for if the use of this old tongue dies out as fast for the next 5 and 20 years as it has for the same bygone period, it will be utterly extinct and forgotten before the present century shall have closed in order for a person not acquainted with the pronunciation of the dialect to form anything like an idea of it, it is first necessary to speak slowly, and remember that the letter A has invariably the same sound, like a in father double ee sounds like e and me, and most words of two syllables the long accent is placed on the last to follow the English pronunciation completely deprives the dialect of its peculiarities Two's Excellency Constantine Harry Phipps, Y. Earl Mulgrave, Lord Lieutenant General and General Governor of Ireland ye sumissive spacking o's dwellers o barony forth, wise forth might be pleasant to Texcellency, we, vassals o, his most gracious majesty, William A. E. Vorth, and, as we verily chote, na cosh and loyal dwellers na barony forth, crave na dick lucky acte to uk niker th Excellency, and na plain grave o or yola taki, why vengum o cortegi ars zense o why grades wilkie bee dite why name, and wilkie we canna Zei, albeit o governor a, statesman, and alike y n urcha and owl o while yt beeth y gleesum o core th or ein dwytheth upon ye viger odiki zuverine, William A. E. E. Vorth, unner foes fatherly zwae or diaz bee spant, as aver ye trad dick londa name wazee kent varee vreen o liberty, and he fo break ye neckers o zelaves mang oursels, var we dwytheth an Ireland as your general hyam, yost, bie rack. Maxim Ohond, ee delt to ye laws ee mate var urcha vassal, ner dwythen na dick way nar dicka we dwyth ye an foes deus be gian var ee guidever oe londa ye zwae, tavance pace and liberty, and, wyote vlinch, ee guard o general rates and poplar vartu ye pace, yea, we my zei, ye vast pace wilkie bee stent owr ye londa zins tost ee cam, prut, ya we elaine needeth ye giftes o general rights, as be Splaith bieee facts oath governmente ye state na dick daie oe londa, na wilkie bnar fash nar moil, albeit constitutional agitation, ye wake. O hopes ee blight, stamp na zwae be rare and lightsome name var zech avancet aver ye, ina dick var high, errant wilkie ye brine ozia and die craggies onagains cast ne balk na or glades anna wilkie we delt y matok, and zingta or calls y plu, we hurt ee zao oe kaluro pace na name o mulgrave y Irishman or general hoops be ee bowed, as Irishman, and as dwellers na caution loyal o barony forth, wool daie and urcha Daie, our minas and or girls, pray var long and happy zins, shorn olorna and ee vilt y benizins, and yourself and or good zavrine, till ee zin o or days be vari bee go toglade standard English translation to His Excellency, Constantine Henry Phipps, the Earl of Mulgrave, Lord Lieutenant General, and General Governor of Ireland the humble address of the inhabitants of the Barony of Forth, Wexford may it please Your Excellency, we, the subjects of His Most Gracious Majesty, William the Fourth, and, as we verily believe, both faithful and loyal inhabitants of the Barony of Forth, beg leave at this favourable opportunity to approach Your Excellency, and in the simple dress of our old dialect to pour forth from the strength or fullness of our hearts, our sense or admiration of the qualities which characterise Your name, and for which we have no words but of governor, statesman, etc. In each and every condition it is with joy of heart that our eyes rest upon the representative of the sovereign, William IV, under whose paternal rule our days are spent, for before your foot pressed the soil, your name was known to us as the friend of liberty, and he who broke the fetters of the slave unto ourselves, for we look on Ireland to be our common country, you have with impartial hand ministered the laws made for every subject, without regard to this party or that we behold in you one whose days are devoted to the welfare of the land you govern, to promote peace and liberty, the uncompromising guardian of the common right and public virtue the peace, yes, we may say the profound peace, which overspreads the land since your arrival, proves that we alone stood in need of the enjoyment of common privileges, as is demonstrated by the results of your government the condition, this day, of the country, in which is neither tumult nor disorder, but that constitutional agitation, the consequence of disappointed hopes, confirms your rule to be rare and enlightened your fame for such came before you even into this retired spot, to which neither the waters of the sea below nor the mountains above caused any impediment in our valleys, where we were digging with the spade, or as we whistled to our horses in the plough, we heard the distant sound of the wings of the dove of peace. In the word Mulgrave with Irishmen our common hopes are inseparably bound up, as Irishmen, and as inhabitants, faithful and loyal, of the barony Forth, we will daily and every day, our wives and our children, implore long and happy days, free from melancholy and full of blessings, for yourself. And our good sovereign, until the sun of our lives be gone down the dark valley of death, the maiden of Rosslare. This following is a Yola poem containing correct spelling and accents from an original document, E.E. Mightyachi O.V. Rosslare Chom Goen to tell the Oa tall at as Drew A.A.R. as Ing Rosslare Oa Mightyachi Geode and Drew Shoe Werth Ing Her Hatte Oa Ribbon at as Blue and Shoe Goeth to E.E. Fytheirchi D. 2 Ik Measle B. Ing E.E. Fytheirchi D. Zoo at Ik Z. Dicka Mightyachi Fo as Geode and Drew and Ik B. to Isholt E.E. Mightyachi, E.E. Mightyachi at as Drew and Fo Coom to E.E. Fythe Y. Ribbon Blue Chol Measle Go to Rosslore or She D2 to Zethar E.E. Mightyachi We Her Ribbon Blue and Chol Her Estolte Vor Her Ribbon Blue E.E. Mightyachi at his Lightsome, and Well Wythin and Drew Ik Louv E.E. Mightyachi We E.E. Ribbon Blue. At Coom to E.E. Fytheirchi Arish 2 Fan Chom Ing E.E. Fytheirchi Arish 2 to Estuth Mightyachi We E.E. Ribbons Blue The Maiden of Rosslare I'm going to tell you a tale that is true. There is in Rosslare a maid good and true. She wears in her hat a ribbon that is blue and she goes to the faith every day too. I myself am in the faith every day so that I see this maid who is good and true and I go to meet the maid that is true and who comes to the faith with ribbons blue. I myself will go to Rosslare every day too to see there the maid with her ribbons blue and I will meet her for her ribbons blue the maid that is enlightened and good looking and true I love the maid with the ribbons blue that comes to the faith every morning too. When I'm in the faith every morning too to meet the maid with the ribbons blue a guide for pronunciation ch and ck are pronounced as tch, example ik pronounced ich dicky pronounced ditch agh, a guttural sound the same as the gh in lock eo jow, yao u o as in boot ee as in be a as in man but longer a as in cat, a as in father e as in let, a as in may, I as in bit, ie as in be, o as in spot, o as in boat, u as in but, u as in boot, y as a mix between the in spin and the ee and b possibly, y and oiy sound not in English possibly speak slowly to find correct pronunciation, e's after words are pronounced examples. Carrot Hickey, Raymond 2005 Dublin English, Evolution and Change John Benjamin's Publishing p.